Okay, Vinay, let's talk about the banking space. And within that space, ICICI Bank, you know, it's along with the Nifty Bank, it's a big loser today in trade. What's your view?
Yeah, good morning, Movina. And first of all, congratulations for being a number one in terms of viewership. Let's start with overall setup with the ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank registered an all-time high at 443 in the month of June 2019, and since then we have been witnessing a lower top, lower bottoms on the charts. So on the daily chart, it has been going bearish. On every higher level, it has been facing some supply issues. So as of now, we are also watching that Bank Nifty has been underperforming. The stock has got strong resistance around 420 odd levels, which is nothing but it's the recent top. So until and unless this level is surpassed on the closing basis, the trend would remain bearish. So 420 is a level to watch out for as a resistance. As far as support is concerned, 388 is a strong support, which happens to be its 200 days moving average support. So if this level is breached, then we can say that it will again face the momentum selling in the counter. So whatever long position traders are having should be kept with a tight stop loss of 388, and overall scenario will improve if it breaks 420 on the upside. So currently it is in the downtrend, and above 420 only one should remain, one should go long in this counter. So short term scenario is bearish as far as ICICI Bank is concerned.
Okay, it looks like Vinay does have a bit of a bearish stance when it comes to ICICI Bank. 4024 now for this one. But Swami, Vinay, United Spirits, you know, it was a bit of a steady performer, but then it cooled down a bit, you know, not doing much. With today's move of 1.5%, anything that you would recommend as a trade that could be executed here?
Yes, you are right. The stock has been a steady outperformer, and in the falling market also it was showing good amount of resilience. And overall on the chart, if you look at it, was trading in the range of 40 rupees. On the downside, 665 was the support, and on the upside it found a support around 565, and on the upside 605 is the range. So this range was holding for last 7 to 8 weeks. Now today what we have seen is that it has given a clear cut breakout on the charts, on the weekly charts in fact. So it's a good development. Our fundamental as well as technical view on this particular stock is bullish. Traders should remain bullish, and 565 should be the trading stop loss in this counter, and the stock is likely to continue its outperformance in the coming times also. So we are bullish on this particular stock, and on the upside, if this 610 is surpassed, then we can expect stock to move on the upside 675 levels. So yes, overall medium to long term charts are also supporting the trend, and we should remain bullish, and investors should also keep this stock in this portfolio. If somebody is not holding this counter, then they should add into on every dips, and ultimately on the long term also this counter is going to give good returns to the investors also.
All right, 1.5% higher for United Spirits today in trade. Swamiya, what's the news around Muthoot Finance?
Well, Muthoot Finance is actually facing a strike from
2.7% higher before Sun and Spark, both of them seeing a coordinated move. And Vinay, Coromandel, you know, we've seen a nice gaining streak come by for the last few sessions. Today, however, it seems to have snapped that gaining move, gaining streak. What's your view? Would you read much into this fall?
Stock has been an outperformer. If you look at the long-term charts, it looks very strong. If we go by the monthly and quarterly charts, it looks very strong. So no doubt in the recent times with the market, it has fallen, and overall it can be considered as a short term in the overall bull market. So I think this week's low is around 336. So that can be kept as a stop loss for the traders. But if somebody wants to invest, then this is a good quality stock. It has been recommended by our company on the fundamental side also. So our view as far, is bullish as far as this fertilizer and chemical stocks are concerned. We are bullish on Coromandel, at least for in the fundamental side. Technically, it has not been that momentum kind of stock in which traders can get the good returns. So it could come down and the consolidation can be there in the near term. But overall, charts are very promising. One should remain bullish, and every dip should be accumulated for the investor. So overall, we are bullish on this counter. But short term, I don't see any trading opportunity in this particular stock.
For the long term, and you know, both on a technical and fundamental basis, HDFC Securities is very positive on a Coromandel. Mahindra Logistics, quick look at that. ICICI Securities has initiated coverage on this one with a buy and a target at 415 rupees as they believe that there is going to be sustained revenue growth momentum, and that would be accompanied by gradual margin improvement as well. So overall, they expect good earnings in FY 20 and 21. Also the fact that, you know, they have this scalable asset-light model and the huge market opportunity, both of this would do well for Mahindra Logistics. The rising, you know, client dependence as well essentially does give Mahindra Logistics that competitive edge. So all in all, they are optimistic, and Mahindra Logistics was gaining a percent, but now it ebbed off from the day's high. Amit Radico Khaitan, you know, most liquor stocks are gaining, but this one is seeing a big fall in trade. What are your observations? Quickly, Vinay, IB Realty, a big loser, even though the realty sector today is absolutely flat, this one certainly is bucking the trend.
Yeah, you are right. Today, the stock is down more than 6.5%, and overall trend has been bearish. It has been forming lower tops and lower bottom. The stock is placed below all important moving averages, and 62 is a recent bottom. If stock breaks 62 level, then it will be a breakdown below the neckline of a bearish head and shoulder pattern, which is being formed on the monthly chart. So I think it is very risky counter, and it is very important for the traders to keep a stop loss at 62 odd levels. If 62 breaks, then one should exit out of the long positions, and if one wants to go long in this particular sector, then the Prestige Estate looks much better on the chart. So traders as well as investors should concentrate on the stock like Prestige Estate, which it belongs to the same sector. So I would give a bearish view on the iGold Real Estate, and if somebody is holding, then 62 should be the strict stop loss.
Alright, Prestige is a better bet if you want to stay within the realty space. Amit Ashok Leyland, after a nice up move to 66, 67, it's now again cooling off today. Anything that you would recommend? Unfortunately, with that, we are out of time. So Amit, Vinay, Soumya and Varun, thank you for joining us on this edition of Market Fatafat. Stay tuned. Coming up at 12 o'clock is Market Central.